students, a very good morning to all of you. This is Dinesh Mehboobani. I am HOD in Chemical Engineering Department at LJ Institute of Engineering and Technology. In this semester, I am going to teach you effective technical communication. Okay. We have already studied that what is the need of the effective technical communication. It is basically used in your academics as well as your professional life. Okay, so the total there are 6 units, and in today's lecture we are going to start unit number 1, that is dynamics of communication. In this chapter we have to study about the basics of communication, that what is communication, what is the basic process of communication, communication model, then we have to study the different levels of communication, then types of communication like verbal and non-verbal, then we have to also study about the interpersonal communication, intercultural communication, and we have to also study about the importance of them. Okay, so let us start the chapter number 1, that is dynamics of communication. Okay, before starting communication, first of all you should know what is the meaning of communication. Now, what is communication? From where this word has arisen? See, as you can see on your screen, the communication has arisen from the word, Latin word communicare, which means to share. Okay, in other words, what is communication? Communication means sharing. Okay, now what we are sharing? So we are sharing our information, we are sharing knowledge, we are sharing ideas. Okay, so this is the definition of communication. It is the process of sharing of knowledge, information and ideas between the sender and receiver. Now for communication, two parties are must, one is sender, another one is receiver. And how they are communicating, how they are exchanging the information? The information is exchanged with the help of accepted code of symbols. Now what is the means? Move further. Let us study about the communication process in detail. Before that, we are going to study about the communication model. Now this topic is very much important for exam point of view, because in each and every exam this topic is definitely going to ask. Okay, so this is the basic communication model in which the communication process is shown. Okay, there are total 5 blocks. Okay, there are total 5 blocks. First one is sender, then encoding, third is channel, fourth is decoding, and fifth one is recipient. Okay, noise is any unwanted disturbance, and that is added in the channel, that is known as noise. We are not considering noise as the main block of the communication model. So which are the main 5 blocks? Once again I am repeating: sender, encoder, channel, decoder and recipient. Now one by one let us study about the functions of each and every block. Okay, here we have simply written the basic function of sender and encoder. Okay, for example, now if we want to do communication, if I want to communicate with you with the help of message or any WhatsApp message or any call, then what I will do? First of all, I will create the message. Okay, first of all I will create the message. For example, I am sending the messages in group. Okay, so I am the sender. So the sender who is forming the message is known as sender. So who is a sender? Sender is a person who is forming the message. The message can be formed in various ways. Okay, then next comes the encoder. The main function of encoder is to provide the meaning to the message. Whatever we are writing, it should contain some meaning. So main purpose of encoder is to provide the meaning, right? Then comes the channel. Now after the message has been generated by the sender and encoder is used to provide the meaning to the message, then that message is forwarded to the channel. Now channel is the media through which we are communicating from sender and receiver. Okay, so media can be air, internet, cables, etc. For example, we are sending calls, we are doing calls, then the medium is air, okay, we are sending emails, then the medium is internet. So this is the different, these are the different medias through which we can send the message from sender to receiver. Now at the receiving side, after sending the message is first of all transmitted to the channel, then channel will forward that message to the decoder. Now what is the purpose of decoder? Decoder is exactly opposite to the encoder, right? So decoder the meaning of the message, okay, and after that the receiver will receive the signal, okay, the message in the decoded form. Fine. There is one more thing that can be added in the channel, and that is known as noise. If sender is sending something and due to some noise in the channel, the whole message gets distorted, the meaning of the message gets changed. So noise is any unwanted information that is added in the message, that will disturb the transmission of message. Okay, fine. After that, there is a feedback channel. Now what is the function of feedback channel? It is a channel from output to input. It is a channel from receiver side to transmitter side, and it is used to revert back the responses. Okay, to revert back the responses. And the feedback signal, or we can also say the response signal, is sent from receiver to sender, and it is one type of acknowledgement that yes, I have received the message. But that is transmitted by the sender and the received, and the message received by the receiver, both are same, then we can say effective technical communication has taken place. And if message is not same, if message sent by the sender is not exactly same as the message received by the receiver, then receiver will send the response to the sender, and sender will get that the message that was sent is not exactly same, so it will retransmit the message. So feedback channel is used to forward the responses from receiver to sender. So this was about the communication process. I hope it is clear to everyone. Our next topic is levels of communication. At which levels the communication can take place? Okay, so there are basically five types of levels of communication. First one is extrapersonal communication, second is intrapersonal communication, third is interpersonal communication, then organizational communication, and the last one is mass communication. Let us study one by one in detail. Okay. Now what is the meaning of extrapersonal communication? The extrapersonal communication is the communication that is taking place between human beings and non-human beings. Okay, that is known as extrapersonal communication. As you can see in the image, the communication that is taking place between animals and the human beings is known as extrapersonal communication. Okay, like machines and robot. Okay, so machines and robots, then birds and animals, these type of non-human entities are involved in the communication. That type of communication is known as extrapersonal communication. I will give you one example. If you are having a pet dog at your home, right, then while you will reach home, it will start wagging its tail. Okay, so this is one type of communication. He or she is knowing that my boss has came. Okay, so we can say the communication that is taking place with the help of actions is known as extrapersonal communication. Now it requires more perfectness, understanding and coordination, because we are not using the words, so responses cannot be shared, so everything has to be assumed, right? So this type of communication is not much effective because it requires more perfectness, coordination between the sender and receiver, and more understanding, right? Now second type of communication is intrapersonal communication. Now the communication that is taking place inside the human body within an individual is known as intrapersonal communication. Like our body parts, with they are connected with brain with the help of electrochemical system, right? like they can sense heat, they can sense cold, and according to that they can respond. So each and every organ of our body is connected with brain. This is one type of communication, right? For example, I am throwing a ball at you, okay, you are standing and I am throwing a ball at you. That means something is coming. Your eyes will see the ball coming towards you. So what you will do? The eyes will send a signal to the brain, and according to that, brain will send a signal to your hands, and your hand will respond. Like you will catch the ball, or you will just be like this, so you can miss the ball or you can catch the ball. So this type of communication is known as intrapersonal, that is taking place inside the human body, right? Like many people have habit of talking with themselves, okay, self-talk, thinking. Again, these type of communications are known as intrapersonal communication. Okay, next one is interpersonal. As the name suggests, inter, that means it is between two people. Interpersonal means between two people. The communication that is taking place between two or more than two close people is known as interpersonal communication. It can be formal or informal. For example, if you are talking with your boss or your HOD, right? So the communication will be formal. And if you are talking with your friend or your colleague or your family member, then that type of communication will be informal, right? So this is more effective. Why it is more effective? Because the sender and receiver can share the responses between them. For example, two people are talking. If one is not able to understand what another is saying, then what he will do? That another person will tell that I am not able to get you. Will you please repeat it again? So on the spot, the communication can become effective with the help of sharing the feedback, right? Okay, the next type of communication is organizational communication, the communication that takes place between the individuals of an organization. For example, you are doing job in any company, right? Then message is floated from your manager, from your boss to many people, right? So that type of communication that is taking place inside a company is known as organizational communication. For example, your headquarters is located at Mumbai and meeting is held, right? Zoom meeting is held, then that type of communication is also known as organizational communication. Basically, these type of communication are done in round table meetings, right? Round table conferences, we can say. Conferences, video conferences, forwarding instructions, and this type of communication is basically formal in nature. Why formal? Because you are working in any company, there are some rules and regulations of that company. So this type of communication will be formal in nature, right? And the last one is mass communication. See, it is basically one type of broadcasting. Okay, broadcasting means it is basically meant for large audience and it needs a medium to transmit the information, right? Broadcasting means one information is sent to many media, right? For example, any blogger is there, and he or she is writing the blogs regarding food, regarding online shopping, regarding travel, then that type of communication we can say it is mass communication. And basically TV, internet, magazines, okay, the users are many, the audience is in a large number, right? So this type of communication is known as mass communication. This type of communication is impersonal because the person, they are unknown to each other. For example, the video that I am going to share on a YouTube channel, right? So I am not able to get who are my listeners, who are watch my video, right? So this type of communication is impersonal. Okay, it should be factual, it should be authorized, because we have to share the information to many people, so it should be authorized. Okay, so check the authority before transmitting anything on internet, right? So this was about the levels of communication. We will study more topics in the next lecture. Till then, have a good day. Bye-bye.